Deputy Pringle. Deputy Pringle, thank you.
Thank you, Ken Corla. Just before I start, Ken Corla, I'd just like to say that you have said that you're going to run strictly by the rules of the House in relation to statements here. I believe the rules are a disgrace. There are 14 independent
deputies
in the
House. Maybe you take that up with the Committee on Procedure.
Which is the same size as the Sinn Féin party.
Thank you.
But yet the 14 independents are not recognised in this House and are asked to offer.
Well, that's a matter for the Committee on Procedure and Privilege. Thank you.
When a sizeable proportion of all of you are gone, we'll still be here.
Sorry, Deputy Pringle, are you finished making your point? If you want to change the rules, change it through the Committee on Procedure and Privileges. Please proceed with your question.
Pat, we have asked on numerous occasions to change the rules, but it seems that the government side won't recognise the mandate of the people on this side of the House.
Exactly.
Now, Minister, you have certainly been handed a poison chalice today to come in and defend the indefensible. It could be said that to lose one junior minister could be seen as misfortunate, but to lose two is certainly careless. I would like to take this opportunity to pay tribute to Deputy Shortall for taking a courageous decision and standing by her and her party's policies. She said last night that the public has a right to expect that decisions on health infrastructure and staffing will be made in the public interest, based on the health need and not driven by other concerns. The question has to be asked of you today, where does the Labour Party stand in this government? When will you accept that health policy has been led by clientelism and been driven into privatisation by your bosses in government? Primary health care centres like Ballyhadreen prioritised, that were not even in the top 200 on the priority list, to be delivered through PPPs, which are licences to print money. I want to put to you today the questions Deputy Shortall asked in the House last week, because so far you have clearly refused to answer any of them. Are you going to reform and strengthen our public health service, or are you going to privatise large parts of it? How will you ensure that access and equity in the health service is guaranteed? Is this the type of health service you want for us? Your Labour Party manifesto claimed that Labour will reform the unfair two-tier health system to reduce the cost of delivering care and use those savings to extend universal access to essential medical care. Will you now tell us once and for all that that promise is dead? How can any other junior Labour minister hope to deliver on these promises when they will not even be able to rely on the support of their party leader?
Thank you. Minister.
Well, first of all, I respect Deputy Pringle's mandate, as I respect the mandate of every deputy in this House. And it's my first opportunity as well to congratulate you on what happened at the weekend in relation to Donegal. And I have to say, it's great to see you here. Can I just say, the leader of the Labour Party, Eamon Gilmore, I attended two very large meetings of the Labour Party, important in the structure of the Labour Party, our National Executive and our General Council, drawn from every part of the country. And I must say, there was a very, very good discussion from both groups in relation to health and in relation to all the matters that face the Labour Party in government, as political parties do in terms of their members. And, you know, Eamon Gilmore was absolutely, you know, fulsome in his support of Roisin Shortall and fulsome in his commendation of the achievements that she has. And those achievements that she's made, both in opposition and in the last 18 months in government, will actually stand when the personality clashes are forgotten, because we will have around this country, we will have a network of 20 to 35 primary care centres. And can I say to you, Deputy Pringle, I appreciate your remarks about PPPs, but it's not possible at the moment because of the weak status of Ireland in terms of its capacity to borrow, to actually have commercially viable PPPs. That actually is part of the problem and one of the reasons why the list would have expanded in order to provide for more viable options in order to get your 20 minimum of clinics done in the time. Because PPPs are just not attractive in the context of Ireland to the financial markets at the moment. If they were, we would have a mechanism, particularly when we get our economic sovereignty back, to actually borrow and to not just do the 20, but to do the whole of the 35. In the meantime, if you are negotiating with a group, like private GPs all around the country, you want to ensure, and this is really the objective in terms of our healthcare system, we want to ensure that as many of our citizens in locations right around the country have access to modern GP facilities. So you can go and get your testing, you can get paramedical services, you can get things like physio, you can get counselling, you can get all sorts of services over and beyond what the traditional GP on their own and a practice nurse provides. That is just such a major reform in our health services, and anybody who uses the health services or who, for instance, supports older people to use the health services just knows how important this achievement is on the ground. And when this is achieved, as it will be, by this government, because in a time of a tight economy, it's been prioritised for spending purposes. I think, as I said, that would be to the credit of Minister Riley, former Minister Shortall and Minister Kathleen Lynch.
Thank you. Deputy Pringle. 1 minute, thank you.
Minister, it certainly was a nice speech, but it didn't answer any of the questions. And Deputy Shortall has clearly shown that the Emperor has no clothes. And four times in public, the Prime Minister could not express the support for Deputy Shortall and her stance that she has taken. And it is true that you can have access to primary medical care, provided you're in the Minister's constituency or you have his ear and you get ones jumped up the list from over 200 up to into the top 35. 18 months into this government, the Labour Party have not even been able to get delegated powers to the junior minister responsibility for primary care. How can Deputy Shortall's replacement expect to be able to deliver on any equitable health policy in the department, particularly when she has to deal with a frontline minister who stated last night that pressure is only for tyres? How can the junior ministers deliver? And is there any point in the Labour Party appointing a replacement to Deputy Shortall?
Thank you.
Well, Deputy Shortall's replacement is a matter for the leader of the Labour Party, Eamon Gilmore, and I'm sure he'll deal with that as quickly as possible. Just let me emphasise again that the outcome here is going to be a win-win for communities right around, for all around, for communities.
Sorry.
For communities right around Ireland. For communities right around Ireland. Because, you know, what we're looking for here, and what, in a time of serious economic problem, we have an economic stimulus, which will put, we hope, local people to work in the different locations around the country. And as our economic conditions improve, my hope and my answer to you will be that our ambition is not just to have 20, it will be to have 35 centres provided to our people right around the country. That's transformative in terms of the health services, and that has been Deputy Shortall's achievement, that she has provided the basis for the pipeline to get community care up and running in this country through a network of purpose-built, designed service community care centres, which will provide the whole range, so that the need for people to go to hospital for tests or to go and stay in hospital to have tests, which is where the costs are incurred in the Department of Health, and everybody knows this, that need will be reduced and we will actually start to have services on the ground that allow so much more to be done at a local level.
Thank you. That concludes leaders' questions for today.